Hey!
How are you?
Hey, God, thanks for coming, Garrett.
Are you kidding, man? I'm thrilled to be here.
I mean it. It's great to have an old friend on the show. How long have we known each other?
Almost 18 years.
See, that's great. That means we can really relate to each other.
Yeah, we can have a real conversation instead of that phony BS you see on a lot of those other talk shows.
Wait, you said phony instead of fake. Supposed to say fake BS.
I'm sorry, that's man. Okay. The light was glaring into the car.
That's okay. Well, let's take it again from we can have a real conversation.
Chevy, look, I realize that you want the show to be perfect, man, but don't you think you're over-rehearsing just a little?
Not at all. Oh, thank you.
It's the Chevy Chase Show from Hollywood. Tonight, from Beverly Hills 90210, Jenny Garth. Martin's Garrett Morris. Teenage Pianist, Sergio Salvatore. News Update. Tom Scott and the Hollywood Express. Now here he is, Chevy Chase.
Thank you at home for letting us into your bedroom. Boy, what an exciting time we live in. We now have peace with the Soviet Union, the Eastern Bloc, and the Middle East, and hopefully someday soon, Florida. Oh! Did you hear about this? Al Gore said this on Larry King the other night. The United States borrows $24 billion a day to finance itself. Who are we going to for that kind of money? And when we get there, doesn't the guy ask, hey, what do you do with the $24 billion I gave you yesterday? I read this in USA Today. The U.S. military plans to use plug-in components in its Navy and Air Force aircraft. Is this a good idea, plug-in parts? Isn't that what caused the tailhook scandal in the first place? Hey, boy, we got a good show for you tonight. 90210's Jenny Garth is here. Garrett Morris, a wonderful 12-year-old pianist, jazz pianist, Sergio Salvatore is here, and news update. And of course, Tom Scott and the band.
Quiet down, please.
A little while ago, we showed a tape that people seemed to respond to. Unfortunately, the first time we showed it, one of our viewers was in his kitchen making a tongue sandwich. So, out of fairness to him, here again, it's the story of my day job. You know, a lot of people think that just because I've been making movies for years and I have my own TV show that I'm rolling in money. It's just not true. I, like so many other folks today, have to work a second job to make ends meet. And that's why I'm here. Hi, Sayed. Mohammed, another day. And here are the members of MASH, featuring that sexy blue-eyed blonde, Father Mulcahy. Marilyn Monroe. Late again. Get into makeup. Finally got rid of that infectious wind.
Did you get a meat thermometer?
Oh, no! See, I told you he was so real.
Are you okay? My gosh, I've never seen anything like that. Are you going to be all right? Come over here. Come here. Come here. I'm not Chevy Chase. I'm just doing this for him as they get, you know, the wax done. Right, John? Here, shake my hand.
No, I'm scared.
Don't be afraid. You can touch it. It's real. Lunch? Bill, it's just about time for lunch. You want to get a bite?
Oh, great, Jerry. Well, let's go over to Denny's. I've got a quick one.
Oh, great. Good. And the other guys come back.
Yeah.
Funny piece. I want to tell you, those two girls at the end were, I scared the pants off them. And I really tried to make them feel better. And we were going to call them, in fact, tonight or last night or any night. But they're Orthodox Jews and they're celebrating the holiday, so we couldn't. But eventually we're going to. But they are real sports because I think there was a cardiac arrest there. Anyway, I want to thank all of you for being here. We got a great show tonight. 90210's Jenny Garth will be out in a minute. Later, Garrett Morris. I found this in my car. I've got three kids. Let's see what they... 100,000 jokes for kids. Let's see what they have in here. Dr. Sawbones speaking. Oh, doctor, my wife's just dislocated her jaw. Can you come over in, say, 3 or 4 weeks' time? We actually are back. My first guest... has America's most famous zip code. You know what that means. She plays Kelly on Beverly Hills 90210. And she's also starring in Danielle Steele's Star, an upcoming movie on NBC. Let's take a look at the clip first.
Ken's obviously very happy with you. So am I. And so is the studio. Here's the script for your next picture. It's your movie. It probably represents an Academy Award nomination. This is for me.
Just keep the necklace, Ernie. Keep it, okay? The rest of the world can think whatever you want, but don't you ever touch me again.
Please welcome Jenny Garth.
How are you?
Just want to wake you up.
Thank you. I'm a little hoarse, sorry.
You're a little hoarse? No, you look fine to me. Oh, you mean your voice? Yeah. Are you really?
Yeah.
Are you nervous or just hoarse?
I'm nervous. Are you nervous?
Very. No, I'm not nervous. Sorry.
I'm such a big fan of yours.
Oh, thank you.
I am.
And I'm a fan of yours, too.
Oh, thanks. You've never watched the show.
Huh?
You never watched the show.
What show? Just kidding you again. Did you enjoy making that movie, Star?
Star? I love making the movie. It's a romance novel, you know, Fantasyland.
Yeah, Danielle Steele.
Yes, I loved it, but I actually had to sing in it. And I wasn't very comfortable with that. But I feel a lot better about singing now, so I want to know if I could sing you a little song.
Please do. What key?
It's my favorite song, and actually it's a song that you sang.
Okay.
Ready? Will you sing it with me?
I don't know. If I know the song, I'll try, yeah.
Ready? Okay, I'm nervous. I was born to love you.
Wait a minute, do that again. I know what this is.
I was born to love you. I was born to lick your face. I was born to rub you, but you were born to rub me first.
I was born to rub you what? I was born to lick your face. I was born to rub
you, but you were born to rub me first.
Yeah, I think when. Wait a second. I was born to love you.
I was born to lick your face.
Right, yeah. I was born to rub you.
Rub you.
You were born to rub me first. Right, yeah. Yeah, that's some catechism. Yeah, yeah. Oh, boy. Yeah, that's right. That's when I had the tequila and the salt and messed it up.
Yeah.
I didn't get to see last night's 90210. What happened? Explain the whole thing to me.
Wait, how old are your kids?
My kids?
Yeah.
Let's see. 2, 5, 8, 12, 17, and 21.
Really?
No. 10, 8, and 5. All girls.
So did they watch the show?
Well, not really. I think they're still a little young for that. Yeah.
They are.
I mean, it's not that it's too sophisticated for them. It's just that...
You should watch it with them and talk to them after.
Actually, I have seen it a few times.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, it's a lovely show. What happened last night that I don't know about? Fill me in.
Well, Brenda went away to Minnesota.
Yeah.
To go to college, and all of a sudden she's decided to come home. Kelly and Dylan broke up, and...
No.
So she thinks she's going to get Dylan back.
Brenda's going to get Dylan back.
Yeah, maybe, but maybe not.
Well, tell me, is she or not? Or you can't tell?
I don't know right now because everyone's kind of loving everyone, so...
Oh. Kind of like beer. I understand that you were Miss Broomcorn, is that correct? Whatever that was? Is that correct? Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Broomcorn.
Thank you. Actually, I was Miss Seedcorn.
Miss Seedcorn?
Seedcorn.
Ah.
When I was about 7 or 8 years old in Arcola, Illinois. And I had to go have my picture taken in a big field of corn by myself. And I was so nervous. This is my first modeling anything. And I threw up on the way.
You did?
Yeah.
How old were you?
Like 7 or 8.
Oh.
My mom had to clean.
You were
my
all alone
out
in the cornfield?
Yeah.
Who took the picture?
Some farmer.
Some farmer? And that's how I got in the business, too. In a cornfield with some farmer. You cut that out. I'll give you something to cry about. You have dogs, I hear, too. I have 4 dogs, and
you
I
do?
Love to talk about dogs, yeah. Anything you
dogs.
Want to talk about, when it's dogs, I'll talk. What kind of dogs do you have?
I have an Akita.
That's enough. No, I was kidding. Yeah.
I have an Akita,
yeah.
I have a mutt
yeah.
that I found, and I have 2 poodles, a mommy and her son, and I have a bird.
What kind of bird?
A cockatiel.
We have one, too, and we have 2 African gray parrots.
Oh, my gosh, I'm afraid of those.
Well, they do bite, but...
They're big.
Yeah.
Elton?
They're not that big, but...
My bird bites everyone but me, so yeah. I'm the only one that can pay any attention to him. It's kind of a pain, but actually we just went camping for the, I had a few days off, so we went camping up in Big Bear. We took all the dogs and the bird because we couldn't leave anyone out.
Well, I want you to tell me about that in a sec. We'll be
okay.
Right back.
All right.
With,
it's so
with
exciting.
You were telling me when we went to
break
that you were... Oh, yeah. If you have a hoarse voice, please.
I have a present for Chevy.
Uh-oh.
I have a doll, and I wanted you to have one, too.
Oh, thank you so much.
This is the Chevy Chase doll.
Isn't that sweet?
I thought it would look good. You know, you could set it up with all your
sure.
other little toys.
Or I could put them in with the fish.
Oh, sure. Yeah, they'd like them.
I didn't think it was going to go, and I really didn't think. We'll fish it out later.
I made that for you.
There wasn't any money in the pockets for you. Did you make that though? You didn't make that doll.
I put a little C on it for you.
Oh, well, we'll get them out of there in a little while.
No, it's okay. You can put my doll in there with it.
All right. You were talking about camping, and you took
camping.
Your four dogs and your bird.
Yeah.
And that was it? Was
yeah.
there anybody else with you? Was...
No, my boyfriend.
Oh, your boyfriend?
My fiance.
Uh-huh. Who's
yeah.
that?
Dan?
Dan the divine? Or
Dan the man.
Dan the man?
Yeah.
Yeah. And you're engaged?
I'm engaged,
Gonna
yeah.
get married?
Gonna get married maybe someday, yeah.
You haven't set a date?
We've been engaged for about a year and a half now.
Uh-huh.
So we kind
so you,
of don't know.
So you know each other pretty
yeah,
well, yeah.
We're getting pretty familiar with each other.
Yeah.
But I like him a lot.
Well, I hope so, if you're going to marry him, yeah.
Yeah.
I would suggest don't marry him until you actually love him.
No,
it's a good
him.
Piece of advice.
No, we just can't set a date. We're both really scared.
Yeah.
And it's so busy right now.
Uh-huh.
And weddings are expensive.
They are, indeed. But you're making a goodly sum, I believe.
Well.
In fact, I know what you're making. But I'm not going to say. And what does he do? Does he help out with the... Does he make any money? Does he work?
He's a musician.
Yeah. Rock? Jazz? Don't want to talk about
him? No, he's a musician. He plays in a rock and roll band called The Hoodwinks.
The Hoodwinks?
The Hoodwinks.
Of course.
Yes.
Yeah.
You've heard of them.
Not only have I heard
Actually,
of them, I manage them.
I thought I saw you at the Coconut Teaser the other night.
The Coconut Teaser?
Yeah.
Yeah, I get there a lot. And then I go to On the Rocks.
Yeah.
And drink a gallon of vodka. All right, well, listen, what are you on me for? Can't you see who's sitting here? Jeez. There you are. Would you like to, were you one of his groupies? Is this
Dan?
How you met Dan? Yeah.
Yeah.
Ah. See, my first wife was a groupie, too.
Oh, great.
Not for me, unfortunately.
Oh.
But I used to be in a rock group, too.
What'd
in fact, I do a lot of music.
You played piano?
I played drums.
Yeah, he's a drummer.
He's a drummer?
Yes.
Uh-huh. I play drums, and I do something with my face that you might want to see.
I'd love to see,
Would
Chevy.
Like to
please.
Yeah. All right, let's just have a little musical interlude with my trio. We'll watch it on the monitors.
Okay.
I was blue, and I was always wearing a frown. Because my gal had turned me down. Then we met and knew too bad I knew from the first. You were my love, cause that's when the old gray cloud burst. Hey, baby, I'm gonna tell you about your love. And then you're kissing and you're hugging and you're sweet, turtled up, pretty baby. I won't be satisfied till you play here from the back. Happy by getting one woman be. Cause I love you, baby, 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 with all my heart. Baby, I know, pretty baby, I know you're the one. Yes, you're the one, I'm doing what I bet you want to make you get your clubbing face. That's what love is, cross, cross.
thought I'd believe that Flippin' didn't really want to ruin the plot. Light as a breeze through the trees, boy. Pleasant as one summer breeze, boy.
I do that all the time. I do that at alone at night at my house.
Those are friends of yours?
Yeah. The other two? Yeah, they're friends of mine.
Yeah.
So how much longer do you think you'll be on 90210? I mean, is this something you want to do for the next 10 years, or you want to go somewhere else?
10 years is stretching it a little bit.
Yeah.
But we're very content. Everything is pretty harmonic right now. Harmonious? Harmonic.
Either way, harmonic is good. Harmonious would be better.
Harmonious. Yeah. Harmonious. We're harmonious. Everything's going well, and the writing, as we get into the fourth season, I guess it is, we're getting into it. So it takes a while to get the storyline set up with us going to college and everything.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going very well.
It can't go much longer. I mean, if you figure then it'll be graduate school, then it'll be 30-something, right?
Right. There you go.
Yeah. Where do you see yourself in 10 years when you're 31?
And I'm 31.
Movies?
Movies, I hope. Yes. Yeah. I just saw a movie I really love, True Romance, with Dennis Hopper, who was here last
night.
Yeah,
that's right. Yeah. I heard it's very good. Yeah.
Patricia Arquette, I'm a big fan of her. She was great. And I'd love to do that.
And did you not just do a television movie?
I did a TV movie. I did two TV movies on my hiatus.
So, well, tell me about them.
Well, the other one was the first one was Danielle Steele's Star, which I told you about.
Yeah.
And the other one is, for ABC, it's called Deadly Lessons, the true story of Lori Kellogg.
Of Lori Kellogg?
Yes.
The serial heiress? Or is it...
No. That wouldn't make for a very good movie.
No, it wouldn't.
But then again...
You want to sing again?
No, I'm fine.
You're starting to relax.
It's a good movie. It's about a woman who conspires to kill her husband or something like that.
Oh, yeah. You don't see many of those on TV.
No.
Listen, thanks a lot for coming. You're a lovely girl. Good sport. We'll be back with News Update.
It's time now for News Update with our anchor, Chevy Chase.
Oh, I don't care if you scream, it's what you scream that counts. I gotta go. Good evening, I'm Chevy Chase. Our top story, 60s anti-war activist Catherine Power, wanted by the FBI for a 1970 Boston bank robbery, gave herself up yesterday after 23 years in hiding. At her arraignment, she stated, quote, "I won't rest easy until all of our boys are back from Vietnam." She also said she couldn't wait to buy the new Jimi Hendrix record and watch Laugh-In. A USA Today CNN Gallup poll has found that 41% of people asked oppose the North American Free Trade Agreement, while the other 59% call it muy bueno. Opponents have denounced the agreement as bad for the environment. In particular, they point out that at least 1 million trees will have to be sacrificed just to make pink slips for American workers when their jobs go to Mexico. On Capitol Hill yesterday, Representative Newt Gingrich spoke out about the lack of health care. He was quoted as saying, "Everyone needs health insurance, especially people who are always getting the crap beat out of them because their first name is Newt." Hello? Hello? Earlier this week, Dr. Jack Kevorkian was charged for a second time with violating the Michigan law against assisted suicide. Kevorkian said if he did go to prison, he would like to be put on a work release program on death row. Pending his appeal, Kevorkian agreed to stop assisting his patients who commit suicide and will simply advise them to vacation in Florida. Pepper spray may become legalized here in California as a defense against rapists and muggers who will feel its effects for up for up to 5 hours. Boris Yeltsin addressed his council yesterday in Moscow. He told them he is happy because not only does he see growth in the Russian economy, but he also sees the presidential liquor cart coming his way. Later, Yeltsin embarrassed everyone when he tried to introduce the president of Armenia to his invisible friend, Harvey. China is mounting an effort to host the Olympic Games in the year 2000. Chinese officials are also hoping to add such events to the Olympics as the tank chase, the Molotov throw, and the 10,000-meter run for your life. And finally, alleged Hollywood madam Heidi Fleiss is starting a new pajama business. A spokesman for Fleiss said that if half as many people get into her pajamas as got into her pants, the line will be a big success. And now, for those of you who may be hard of hearing, I will repeat the top story of the day, aided by the headmaster of the Los Angeles School for the Hearing Impaired, Garrett Morris. Our top story tonight...
Top story tonight!
60s anti-war activist Catherine Power has given herself up after 23 years in hiding.
Has given herself
and that's the news. Good night, and have a pleasant tomorrow.
That's the news.
Maybe you've heard that smoking cigarettes increases your chances of getting cancer. And maybe you've also heard that secondhand smoke increases your risk of getting lung disease. But you probably haven't heard this. Inhaling third-hand smoke restores and rejuvenates dull, lifeless hair. And it gently adds luster, silkiness, and body while it repairs split ends. So for great-looking, salon-perfect hair, inhale all the third-hand smoke you want. Isn't your hair worth it? This message brought to you by the Tobacco Growers Association of America.
Claims made for third-hand smoke are not supported by any scientific research whatsoever. We just wish they were.
Tomorrow on the Chevy Chase Show, Al Franken, singer Olita Adams, and a man who loves lizards. But stay tuned for more with actor Garrett Morris and 12-year-old pianist Sergio Salvatore.
Thank you so. I'm very excited because of my next guest. I haven't seen him in about 20 minutes. He's a former member of the Not Ready for Primetime Players on Saturday Night Live, where baseball was very, very good to him. And currently, you can watch him every week on Martin. Please welcome Garrett Morris.
Give a hand for Mr. Tom Scott, fabulous saxophone player. Man, yeah.
Tom?
Man?
Tom?
Man, do you realize you have Sergio and Tom on the same stage tonight? Do you realize that?
I realize. Oh. And Tom, was that the theme to Saturday Night Live you were trying to play?
That certainly was.
Because nobody knows that melody.
I don't know it myself.
Chevy, I think this thing back here is a little bland. Don't you think it's a little bland?
Well,
that aquarium.
Yes.
So I brought you something to add a little color to your aquarium.
Is that a double entendre?
Oh, a double entendre.
That's a good thing. Welcome
This is a Moorish idol.
Let's put him in there.
He's just idling there.
Yeah.
His name is Moorish, and he's idling there.
He's beautiful. Jim, you got a ladder? Is Jim around? Jim, I need you. Do I just drop the whole thing in?
Just drop the whole... No, man, open the bag, Chevy.
Open the bag!
I can't get the bag open. It's one of those Ziplocs. Oh, baby. Okay, easy does it, boy. Easy, boy. Easy. He's in there. Yeah. Oh, geez, I can't. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you very much. That's a beautiful present. That fish tank is going to, that fish tank's going to get better. It takes 6 weeks for the biology of it, the ecology of it to get ready.
Well, he's now what is commonly known as a token, let's just face it. So if he does have any problems, since I have some I have some experience in that.
Yeah.
Just
with fish?
Give him my number, yeah. And we'll talk it over.
Oh, I really
stress. Yeah. You know?
Because he's,
Yeah, I like your show, man. You know, I really do.
Thank you.
Great show.
Well, don't you miss Saturday Night? I do.
Yeah, some of it, yeah. I mean, I miss the creative thing that the search, it was like, you know, the adrenaline every week, you know?
Yeah. The camaraderie, the creativity. Yeah,
yeah. Help me out there, yeah.
Garrett, you know, Garrett started as a writer on the show.
Yes, I did, yeah.
And became a... Tell how you...
I had a play called The Secret Place, which Lauren wrote, read.
Yeah.
And he took me on as a writer. He didn't know that I had done some movies, one of which was Cooley High. And when he brought me on the show, he had me bringing in a lot of black actors and actresses to audition for the show. And John, I think Gilda, Lorraine told him about the movie. They were showing the movie in the green room. I come to work, Lauren gets me in there. He sees it, he digs it and tells me to audition. And I was as nervous as I could be because I wasn't like you guys. You guys were just fast messing us at that kind of stuff.
You weren't improvisatory.
Most of my improvisation was very militant. I was in Leroy Jones's workshop, yeah. Right? So anyway, but because of one factor, and that was Gilda, she was just so, she was just so relaxed. You know, I mean, she's a past master at that. And I just kept my eyes on her eyes throughout that whole, it was like an eternity, right? Because
The audition
was really, it would have been really traumatic if it hadn't been for just.
Wait a minute, Garrett.
Are we still?
Have you died? What happened? Ah, here we are.
and really, if the only thing that saved me
the only thing that saved me
was Gilda, really.
Yeah. Well, I saved you too on a few sketches.
Well, you saved me on a lot
of
sketches.
Yeah, yes, yeah, yes. Yeah. Well, now we're both at Fox. How does that feel?
Fox is great, man. Yeah. I'm with them with the number one show on Fox, really, Martin. Yeah. Thank you.
We have a clip of Martin.
We have a clip,
yeah.
Right.
You
right.
Want to set it up?
Yeah, I'll set it up. Okay. We got Martin Lawrence, Tashina Arnold, Tisha Campbell, Tommy Ford, Carl Payne, John McGrath, myself in this show. And in this particular episode, I'm trying to get Martin straight on his attitude towards women because it leaves a little bit to be desired, okay? So just check him out, and I'm trying to get him straight on his attitude towards women and what it really should be.
All right. Roll it.
See, man, even Sean knows. Martin, I hate to say it, but you are whipped.
Brother, you got the wrong man. I ain't whipped.
No, brother, I don't have the wrong man, and I'm going to prove it to you with the Stan Winters Are You Whipped test.
Whatever, Stan.
Question one. Do you hold her after making love to her? Yes.
I think any decent brother would.
Well, after holding her, you do ask her to leave, don't you?
Stan, man, you a bugging, bro.
Martin, this ain't looking too good. Last question. When she talks to you, do you ever find yourself listening?
Go ahead, Stan.
Martin, I don't need to go no further. You are so whipped, I could spread you on my sandwich.
Before I say goodbye to you, I want the audience to know that you're 57 years old. You look incredible.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Don't go. We'll be right back with Sergio Salvatore, so stay with us. All of you who love jazz will know one of my next guests, the great jazz man Chick Corea. He's here tonight to introduce us to a 12-year-old jazz prodigy named Sergio Salvatore. Please welcome both of them. Sergio! Picked up on those pretty fast.
This is number 65.
This is your 65th?
No.
What? Number 65? This one?
Yeah.
And this is number one.
Oh, this is Chick's.
Oh, yeah.
Let's get a camera on this. This is Chick Corea's 65th CD. Can you see that? Am I holding it right? How's that? Yeah. Can you see it?
Sergio's first. Just recently made.
And this is Sergio's first CD. Thanks for telling me. You're a great jazz pianist for your age.
Thanks a lot.
Why did you start playing jazz? What?
Well, jazz was just always, you know, in my house. So, my father's my piano teacher, and you know he would practice every day, and he'd practice, you know, classical stuff. He'd practice jazz stuff. He'd practice original stuff, and I was always listening to it when I was younger, so I just picked up on it.
Just picked up on it?
Yeah.
You read music, I'm sure.
Yes.
And do you go to a conservatory and study, or do you...
No, I just go to a regular school.
Regular school?
Yeah.
Chick? Do you go to school anymore?
Never went to a conservatory.
What? Never went to a conservatory.
Got by that one.
Weren't you at the Berklee School jazz for a while?
I used to go and jam at Berklee.
Yeah, I went there and tried to jam. Realized I was out of my league. What are you going to play for us tonight?
Well, I'll play Someday My Prince Will Come.
It's a great song.
Yeah. Take two.
Huh?
Take two. Thank you.
travel arranged through Continental. One airline can make a difference. One pass lets you earn free travel faster than any other airline. That's the difference on Continental.
All right, thank you very much. I hope my brother Ned Chase is watching and saw this kid Sergio because he's great. He's going to be in Carnegie Hall in November, and this is his first CD, and this is Chick Corea's 65th CD, Paint the World. And tomorrow we're going to have Corbin Burnson and Al Franken and singer Olita Adams and an amazing lizard lover. And I'd like to thank very much Jenny Garth, Garrett Morris, Sergio Salvatore, Chick Corea, Tom Scott, and the Hollywood Express. Good night, everybody.
Hotel accommodations provided by the Bellage, West Hollywood's deluxe all-suite hotel, combining sophistication and contemporary elegance. Bellage, a refuge from everything ordinary.